My name is Nicola Dalbeth. I'm a rheumatologist. I work in rheumatology practice in Auckland, and I'm also currently president of the New Zealand Rheumatology Association. So I'm going to just talk through some of the advice that I give patients when I see people with arthritis and autoimmune rheumatic disease in my clinic. And so here I'm really talking about the Pfizer vaccine, which is the vaccine that's available and currently being used in the vaccine rollout in Aotearoa, New Zealand. So the first advice that that I think is really important is that as rheumatologists, we're recommending that all people with arthritis and autoimmune rheumatic disease do receive the COVID-19 vaccine. We know from overseas studies that people with rheumatic diseases, particularly if they're on immunosuppressive medicines that we commonly use to treat conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis and lupus, are at higher risk of severe illness and poor outcomes if they do get infected by the novel coronavirus. So it's really important that people with arthritis are protected from COVID-19, and vaccination is really the most important strategy that we have. I would also recommend that family members and people who are living in the same household also get vaccinated, because this is one of the things that your family members and the people that you're living with can really do to protect you as well. As far as some of the questions that we often get asked by patients, one of the important questions that patients often have is, well, will this cause my arthritis or my rheumatic disease to flare when I get the vaccine? And of course, many of us who have received the vaccine, have had some minor side effects from the vaccine. Certainly I had a really sore arm, particularly after the second dose, which lasted for about 48 hours. Some people also develop flu-like symptoms for a day or so after the vaccine. And that's really evidence that the vaccine is working and is inducing an immune response. The good news from really big studies that have now been done overseas, including thousands of people with rheumatic disease who've had the vaccine, is that it doesn't appear that the vaccine will trigger a flare of arthritis or other autoimmune rheumatic disease. So I think that's really reassuring. Again, I think provides us with more comfort about the vaccine for people with arthritis. Another question that patients often have is the vaccine safe with the medicines that I'm on? And the answer really for all arthritis medicines is yes. And for the vast majority of arthritis medicines, we don't make any changes to either the vaccine schedule or the medications. There's a couple of exceptions to that. One is methotrexate, which is an arthritis medicine that we often use in rheumatology. Now, the vaccine is safe for people who are taking methotrexate, but what we do recommend is that if you're taking methotrexate, and most people would be taking this on a weekly basis, that you withhold the methotrexate the week after you have the vaccine. And that's not because of concerns about safety. It's just really that we want you to have the best possible immune response to the vaccination. So say if you take your methotrexate on a Monday, if you get vaccinated on a Friday, you just hold the methotrexate the next Monday and then carry on as normal. And then you do the same thing again when you have your second dose. No changes are needed if you're taking sulfasalazine, hydroxychloroquine, leflunomide, if you're taking Humira, etanercept, or Enbrel. Just have the vaccine, continue to take your medicines as you normally would. The other medicine that we do need to think a little bit more about is rituximab. And again, it's safe to have the vaccine if you're on rituximab, but rituximab does seem to really have quite a profound impact on the immune response and the antibody response to the vaccine. So as rheumatologists, we do need to think a little bit more carefully about the timing of the vaccine with respect to when you're having your rituximab infusions. So that is a situation where you would want to be talking to your rheumatology nurse or your rheumatology doctor about that. And another question that people, particularly with lupus, have is this medicine safe for me with respect to the risk of blood clots? And many of you will be aware that for some of the other vaccines, particularly the AstraZeneca vaccine, that there does seem to be a higher risk of blood clots, and that could potentially be of concern for patients with lupus and for those who have a higher risk of blood clotting. The great news is that the Pfizer vaccine that we're using in New Zealand isn't associated with an increased risk of blood clots. So again, it's safe for you to take if you have lupus or if you have a history of blood clots as well. So basically, the key message is that we're recommending COVID-19 vaccination for all people with arthritis and with autoimmune rheumatic diseases. For the vast majority of medicines, sulfasalazine, hydroxychloroquine, leflunomide, Humira, Enbrel, continue with your medicine and the usual vaccine schedule. And just some minor changes required if you're taking methotrexate, to just withhold the methotrexate that week after each injection. And finally, if you're taking rituximab, that does require more discussion with your rheumatology team around the timing of the vaccine.